When teaching students about transformations of graphs, the Prizm's dynamic graph feature can offer insights that are difficult to come by using pencil and paper techniques. Dynamic graphing allows users to adjust parameters on an equation and see how those adjustments affect the graph. After selecting Dynamic Graph from the main menu, you'll see a screen which looks very similar to the standard graphing display, but dynamic graphing offers a different set of features. With dynamic graphing, you can use the letters, accessed with alpha, to represent parameters that the Prizm will vary to produce an animated graph. This allows students a powerful visual representation of graphical transformations. To do an investigation of the slope of a line, start with the simple equation y equals x, but place a coefficient a in front of x. Now you have the option to set limits on how large and small you'd like the parameter a to be, as well as how much you want to increment a in each frame of the dynamic animation. Selecting speed with F3 allows the user to decide how fast the animation should be. Finally, select Dynamic with F6 to animate the graph. Now you'll see an animated version of our graph, allowing the user to see how the graph of y equals ax is affected as a is changed to different values. With each increment of a, both the graph and the a value displayed in the lower left corner adjust. You're not limited to a single parameter. In fact, dynamic graphing comes with a set of built-in functions, all of which have multiple parameters. This time, let's take a look at the built-in function for sine. Since this is a trig function, a different viewing window is appropriate. The shift button allows access to the viewing window in dynamic graph, where we'll select trig. This time, let's vary b. We'll get the best look at the effect B has on the sine function if we set A to 1 and C to 0. Under Speed, Stop and Go is selected. With Stop and Go, the user controls how quickly the parameter is adjusted using the left and right arrow keys. By adjusting the B parameter, the student can see how B affects the period of the graph. It's even possible to adjust the same parameter in more than one graph at the same time. In this example, students have the opportunity to observe similarities in the graph's behavior when adjusting a coefficient on a linear, quadratic, and cubic function simultaneously. Dynamic graphing isn't limited to functions. Users also have the option to explore both polar and parametric graphs. Here's an example of a dynamic polar graph. Prizm's dynamic graphing is perfectly suited to allow students insights into transformations of graphed equations in a way that graphing a single equation at a time simply can't. Whether you are investigating the slope and y-intercept of a line or are digging into transformations of sinusoidal graphs, dynamic graphing is the right tool for the job.